Hey guys, welcome back. Alien360, your host, and this time around I'll be bringing you the Geothermal Valley Challenge Tombs. This one's going to be in the Aqueduct area, and we're going to head on in.
Basket made of silver. Certainly meant to be decorative, but someone's been using it to carry grain.
Someone broke into this place in the dead of night. They filled their pockets with coin, turned over urns of oil and wine, and saw fit to show disrespect to all that are interred here. It shreds my heart to think that one of our own could be so callous as to desecrate this place, all for a momentary earthly gain. We must find a way to keep this place safe, even from our own brothers.
Use the other spool to get the raft closer to the island.
Thank you.
Interesting. Did they embalm their dead? A golden chalice fit for a king. Or a prophet. It was made here, in Katesh.
Guys, and there you have the burial chamber tomb complete. Thank you for watching, and we will see you on the next one. Hey guys, welcome back. Alien360, your host, and this time we're bringing you another challenge tomb in the Geothermal Valley. We'll have to have the rebreather in this one as well, as I believe all the challenges in the Geothermal Valley. Or the tombs anyway.
Inlaid with ivory and gems. Interesting. It's been altered with this rough strap of leather, and it's been used to store plants. An ivory jar. It looks like it was carved from a single tusk. A simple thing, but the level of detail in the carving is impressive.
The dead choke the rivers. Our children's blood is spilled on the valley floor. We live, but with what? Our city entombed? Our sons and daughters murdered? Is it courage to go on? Or madness? Those who fell know peace now. When will we?
a way to get in there. Damn. It's not gonna stay. Must be some way of keeping it in place. So many dead. What happened here? No sign of other violence. Appears to be an instruction manual for mountaineering.
Alright guys, and there you have Baths of Katesh, the challenge tomb completed. Hope the video helped you out, and we will see you on the next challenge tomb. Hey, welcome back guys, Alien360, your host, and this time I'm coming to you with another Geothermal Valley challenge team.
Something's back there. I knew the risks. It was only a matter of time before the city guard caught me. By day, I must pull gold and other ore from the rock until my fingers bleed, all to increase the wealth of Kitesh. By night, we do penance, ask forgiveness from God and the Prophet. They hope to save our souls, to rehabilitate us. I bow when they expect me to, put on a mask of regret when they remind me of my sins. But when they let me free of this place, I will take my pleasures where I can. Old ring, tied to a leather thong to create a loop. They had no need of jewelry. A pair of gambling dice. Common thing for soldiers, but these are a little more opulent than most. Hold on. This one has six on most of the faces. Thank you.
wealth of this valley continues to reveal itself like a flower in bloom. Every year, new buildings rise from the wilderness. We have produced a generation of artisans, astronomers, and philosophers that rival anything back west. But with any great city comes crime and rot. Many thought we should have put these sinners to death, but the prophet would not hear of it. He believes all men can be healed, and so we keep them alive, teach them through hardship and scripture. I do not share the prophet's faith that they can be redeemed, but at least they will serve the city and those they wronged.
Byzantine knowledge of mining and metalwork.
Alright guys, the Pit of Judgment challenge tomb completed. Hope the video helped. Thanks for watching, and we will see you on the next one. Hey guys, welcome back. Alien360 with you, and we're bringing you the Crypt mission in the Geothermal Valley. This one's going to be on the summit, right behind the waterfall. You just have to drop your weight down these highlighted rocks to get to it, and then just jump behind the waterfall. You will have to have the rebreather to get to this area. I don't know why you have to have a rebreather. I think we could have held our breath that long, but such is the game.
Rivka joined the prophet because her husband, a Rus nobleman, was a believer. When he died on the journey north, she stayed with the prophet, pondering what her place was amongst the believers. When she saw the valley, she knew she had found her purpose. She dreamed what Kotesh could be. She laid those dreams out to be built. It is because of Rivka that Kotesh became not just beautiful, but livable.
Rivka, the architect.
Alright guys, and that will complete Rivka the Architect tomb, and we will see you on the next one. Hey guys, welcome back. Alien360, your host with you, and this time around I'm bringing you the final tomb in the Geothermal Valley. So let's get on with it. Thank you.
the physician.
The road to Katesh was long and hard. Infirmity, illness, and injury abounded. Aurora was a believer trained in the ways of Hippocrates and the great Roman healers. It is because of her that so many survived the journey to Katesh. It is her legacy that knowledge of healing continues to be passed down among believers.
And there you have it, guys. The final town is Tomb of Geothermal Valley. Hope the video helped, and we'll see you on the next one.